Thanks, Formation, for sponsoring this video. Imagine if the difference between you getting your dream job and increasing your total compensation was spending several months prepping aggressively for technical interviews.
Hey everyone, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'll be giving you the best resources, the best tips to pass your technical interview as someone who's passed multiple six-figure technical interviews. And I also have a couple guests to help me in this video. They've also passed several technical interviews and also given technical interviews at the top tech companies. Let's start with the first tip. Don't set a timeline for yourself. One of the mistakes I made was thinking that I'd be able to master the interview process in about 3 months. You don't know how long the process is going to take, and you don't want to restrict yourself by having a very strict deadline on when you want to perform. Focus instead on mastering the concepts and then interviewing once you've mastered the concepts. This is what Sophie had to say about this.
If you want a fixed schedule, then you have to be okay with variability of outcome. But if you want to be staying ready and that's what you want to guarantee, then you should be more flexible in terms of what material you consume and the time that it takes.
For certain people, the interview process will take a couple weeks. For others, it might take several months. Creating a schedule focused on mastery and only interviewing when you've consistently done well in your practice will allow you to have better outcomes when it comes time to passing technical interviews.
My next tip is that you need to master the fundamentals of data structures and algorithms. So before I even started my journey, the most important thing I did was take a data structures and algorithms class. As someone from an untraditional background in tech, I don't have a CS degree and I didn't go to a bootcamp. This was the key aspect that really helped me during my study process. I took this class, UC Berkeley data structures and algorithms class, and it really provided a good foundation for learning and understanding data structures and algorithms. And it wasn't enough just to take the class. While I was taking the class, I took really detailed notes. I created a study guide for myself and I structured my notes in this way. First, I put the data structure and algorithms. I wrote a definition of the data structures and algorithms. I wrote down the time complexity of the data structures and algorithms for insertion, deletion, addition. Then I actually wrote the code to build the data structures and algorithms. And if it was an algorithm, I implemented the algorithms in code. By writing the study guide, it really helped solidify the knowledge that I gained. And then it wasn't enough just to have that study guide. I also turned that study guide into flashcards so that I could consistently reflect and read and study those data structures and algorithms as I was getting closer and closer to the interview process. If you're someone who's already taken a data structures and algorithms class in your formal CS degree or in your bootcamp, then you might not need to take a class. You might be able to use resources like Cracking the Coding Interview and Elements of the Programming Interview to get a high-level overview of the data structures and algorithms. If you're deciding instead of doing the course to use these books, I would also recommend that you check out ESCO's Trello board. If you remember Esco from my dev stories, he is the self-taught software engineer making $500,000 at a top tech company, and he recommends using a Trello board to organize your studying.
Regardless of what study path you decide to take, your interview study session needs to start by making sure you have the correct foundation and really understand data structures and algorithms. If you're someone who's already done a lot of studying on your own and you just want mentorship and feedback, I'd recommend checking the sponsor of today's video, Formation. Formation provides a customized training program created to help you land your dream role. You'll learn how to master the interview process from data structures and algorithm questions to system design questions. You'll have access to mentors who are talented engineers working at top tech companies, mock interviews with engineers from these top tech companies, and the opportunity to build a network of software engineers. These are some of their alumni, and as you can see, they are consistently placed at some of the top companies in the industry. If you're interested in Formation, check out my link in the description box below.
Once you have the fundamental knowledge of data structures and algorithms, my next tip is that you need to actually practice these interview questions. There are numerous websites you can go to practice coding interview questions, but the most popular one is LeetCode. The only problem with LeetCode is that it's extremely overwhelming because you have so many questions, it's really hard to know where to start, which is why it's good to supplement your LeetCode practice with a more structured approach. The approach I'd suggest is by doing the more popular questions because those questions are gonna have more bang for your buck and you're more likely to see them during the interview process. There's this really great list called Blind 75 Top Interview Questions that was compiled by a developer and published on the Team Blind website. You also want to use Blind 75 list in conjunction with this website that structures each question by topic and then also structures each question by difficulty. In your interview prep process, when you're studying, you want to make sure that you're starting first with the easy questions and only moving on to the medium questions when you've really mastered those easy questions. solutions. And by mastered, I mean that you are able to get the optimal solution and you understand why it's the most optimal solution. And if you're having trouble really mastering the different concepts in these data structures and algorithm questions, I'd recommend that you check out these YouTube channels that really do a good job explaining why certain solutions are the most optimal solutions. And this is a bonus tip. When you're doing your leak code questions, you want to make sure you're doing your leak code questions time because you want to simulate interview conditions where you'll have to answer your interview questions in 30 minutes or less time. You also want to make sure you're answering your questions out loud because you want to simulate interview conditions by making sure you get comfortable with explaining why you chose your solution out loud. When you're explaining your questions out loud, what you want to make sure you're doing too is you're using this 5-step process I actually got from another YouTuber called Keep On Coding. In this 5-step process, you want to make sure that you're starting first by asking clarifying questions. These questions are oftentimes purposely vague because to be a good engineer, you need to know how to ask the right questions that refine the scope of the problem. Next thing you want to make sure is that you're diagramming. Sometimes to understand how to solve the questions, you need to actually draw out the most optimal solution for specific questions. Next thing you want to do is write down your pseudocode or the steps before writing down the code. By writing out the steps, you can kind of see if your solution is going to work. The next step is to translate your pseudocode to actual code. And the final step is having good test cases. When you're interviewing, usually the interviewer will ask you to test your solution by having good test cases. So make sure when you're answering your questions, you have ideas of what good test cases would be. So once you've gotten comfortable answering medium level leak code questions in less than 30 minutes and you're comfortable answering them out loud, the next step in your studying process is to do mock interviews. We talked previously about simulating real life conditions. The best way to simulate real life conditions is by actually doing mock interviews with other people. When I was doing my interview prep process, this was really important for me. I not only did interviews online through websites like Pramp.io and Interviewing.io, I also did interviews in person with other software engineers through the program I did. When you're actually doing your mock interviews, you realize that there's so many things that can happen. You can get nervous, you can stutter over your words. Doing more mock interviews just gets you more comfortable with talking to other people and, you know, it helps you feel less nervous during the interview process, which is why it's really important to end your interviews prep process by doing more mock interviews.
Strategize like how to approach these different conversations in the perspective that you're talking to. And I think that's just the mental hurdle of just like, oh, you can study a problem, but if you're unable to communicate it and unable to demonstrate it so that like you do have a plan, you do have preparations, but then it's just like, how do you be present in the time that you may not have the direct answer for? Like, how do you sort of adapt and rebound in those situations?
There you have it, a couple tips and resources that you should use in your journey to mastering the technical interview process. And remember, all the work you do is going to be worth it because it's going to have significant impact on your compensation. Thank you guys so much again for watching this video. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and tap that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys next time.